home to your tender sweet loving. You're my one and only woman. The world needs a bitter taste in my mouth, girl. You're the only one that I want.
And I won't leave you. Always be true. 1 + 1, 2 for life. Over and over again. Don't ever think I need more. I've got the one to live for. No one else will do. And I'm telling you, just put your heart in my hand. Promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. Yeah, we'll stay brand new. Cause I love you over and over again. Over and over again. From the heat of night, the break of day, I'll keep you safe and hold you forever. And the sparks will fly, will never fade. Cause every day gets better and better. And I won't leave you. Always be true. 1 + 1, 2 for life. Don't ever think I need more. I've got the one to live for. No one else will do. Yeah, I'm telling you. Just put your heart in my hands. I promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. Yeah, we'll stay brand new. Cause I love you. When I'm without you, you're stuck on my mind. Be all you need till the day that I die. I'll love you over and over again.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'd just like to say how stunning and beautiful Samantha looks today. I can't tell you how proud I am to be stood here, and how proud myself and Sam's mum are of a beautiful young woman who have become and what you have achieved so far in life, Sam. So where do I start? Kind, intelligent, beautiful, charming. Sam, I can't read the rest of that. I can't read your writing, you'll have to tell me what it says. No, all jokes apart, Sam was born in Harrogate Hospital on the 25th of September 1991. Sam was a gorgeous baby. I remember bringing her home from hospital and she slept through everything. Sonia's singing and My Queen records. And Sonia's singing was bad. Sam soon grew up, so did her personality. Sam started infant school in Starbeck, and I can remember the Easter bonnet competitions where we made hats together. We sat there on a night making massive hats, which she had to take up to school, and the next day they had to parade two by two down Starbeck High Street. But you knew which one was Sam because she was on her own, because her hat was that big, she couldn't get anywhere. But she did win a few, I think. After infant school, Sam went to Granby High School, which was just down the road from where she lived with her mum and Neil. I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank Neil for being involved in Sam's upbringing for the past 20 or so years. Thanks, Neil. 25 years, thank you. In Sam's teenage years, I remember Sam's first encounter with alcohol. At 14, when she was questioned by police in town after having a little too many, Gemma soon came to her rescue and picked her little sister up. I found out later, actually. Sonia told me about it. So she wanted me to talk to Sam, which I went round, and Sam was extremely upset. And I told Sam that I was disappointed and upset with her too. Obviously, because she didn't invite me. When Sam was 17, she started driving lessons, which I've heard that the driving instructor called her Sam Schumacher. And I don't think anything's changed today, Sam, has it? He's still mad in a car. Also at 18, on many occasions, after being out on a night in high heels, Sam was known as Bambi on Ice. There's a pattern here with this drinking, you know, Sam. I think it comes from your mother. Excuse me a minute. Sam was growing up into a beautiful young woman whose career has got bigger and better each year. So me and Sonia and all the family could not be more proud of her and what she has achieved in life so far. Honest, hard-working, good-looking, good laugh, kind. But that's enough about me, and we're on about you now, Kirk. No, Kirk is all what I've said and more. And I would like to welcome Kirk to the family with open arms, and Sam could not have picked a nicer bloke. So well done, Sam. I know Kirk will look after Sam, and I know how much he loves her and cares for her. I've got to say something about the stag night, Kirk. On the stag night we went karting, and first place was Jack, your younger brother, wasn't it? But although you lost that day, Kirk, you're definitely a winner today. Finally, can I ask you to raise your glasses and toast the bride and groom, Sam and Kirk, Mr. and Mrs. Picard. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you all, family and friends, on sharing this special day with me and my wife. On behalf of me and my wife, we'd really like to thank you for coming here. It wouldn't be the same without it. It'd be much cheaper. I know as Yorkshire folk, like anything for now. We are so grateful for your kind words and gifts and generosity. It does really mean a lot to us. Thank you. I'd also like to say a big thank you from the bottom of my heart to Sam's family who have welcomed me with open arms and to be a part of their amazing family. And what a great family it is too. Words can't describe what you all mean to me. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Sam, you are everything to me. You've changed my life completely. You are the most kind and caring, hard-working woman I know. And you are naturally beautiful who doesn't need makeup. I'm looking forward to spending the rest of my life with you and starting our own little family. Now we've moved into our new house. I know you're going to be an amazing woman when we have children. I love you forever and always. Thank you. Can I just make a toast to my beautiful wife?
Yeah. Evening everyone. I've tried to keep this short, like Kirk. Before writing this speech, I was a little bit stuck, so I turned to Google. Apparently the best man's speech shouldn't last longer than a groom making love. If that's the case, I should sit down now, shouldn't I? All joking aside, it's an honour to be your best man, Kirk. And I think everybody will agree with me that, Sam, you look absolutely beautiful today. Kirk, you look alright. You could have done your hair like, but... I think we should all raise a special glass for Sam. For one, putting up with him. And for two, being forced into marriage, because you deserve a medal. So to Sam. I could spend all evening telling you stories about Kirk, how funny he is, and what an heart of gold he has. Everybody in this room will probably have a story about him, and probably have a laugh about what he's done. I could tell you all the times about him pulling my pants down in the gym. He found it funny, but I didn't find it funny. That's why I don't go to the gym anymore. Lastly, you deserve this, both of you. You deserve the beautiful weather, you deserve all these people here, because you're a special couple. I wish you both the best in the future. I hope it's filled with joy, happiness and love. So can we all raise a glass to the happy married couple, Kirk and Sam.